Well, thank you, Julianne. I thank you for agreeing to moderate, and thank you to Jason for hosting the event. Patrick, congratulations to you on your new role. I'm excited to have you there for the next 9 months. We have an amazing amount that we can do together, you and I. And my message to you tonight is, as we sit here right now, you and I have never been more powerful as United States citizens. We've never had more influence on that process that goes on in Washington than we do right now. And I would tell you that's good news, because this has been a community of problem solvers. It's less important for us to figure out who to blame for it, and more important for us to figure out how we can play a role in fixing it. That has been the reputation I have tried to develop in Congress with your voting card since you first lent it to me in 2011. I'm incredibly proud of what we have done together. And it will come as no surprise to you to know that the last 12 or 13 months have been much easier to get things done than those previous 6 years. The entire success of conservative politics, the entire success of the Republican Party hinges on us being able to look each other in the eye and say, we're making a difference today that's going to make tomorrow better than yesterday was. That's the standard I use when I wake up every day with your voting card on Capitol Hill. Did we make a difference together today? I hope you can feel the difference that we're making together. I hope your family feels the difference that we're making together. And I am incredibly pleased to be here with you tonight and talk to you about where we have come from and where we can still go together. Thank you very much, Julianne.
Thank you, Congressman Woodall. Mr. Hazel.
Well, good evening, everybody. My name is Shane Hazel. I'm running for U.S. Congress here in the Georgia 7th, obviously. I grew up here, and I'd like to thank you all for coming out to be a part of this process. Thank you to the Forsyth County GOP. Rob, thank you for coming out tonight and being part of this. Thank you guys is not enough, because it's the Georgia 7th is my home. I have lived here almost my entire life. I went to Brookwood High School, graduated in 1998. Shortly after 9/11, I joined the United States Marine Corps, where I was fortunate enough to do two deployments with 1st Force Reconnaissance Company, fought through the battles of Najaf and Fallujah, a lot of things that I saw that I don't want anybody to ever see here in America. When I got done, I moved back here to Forsyth County. I graduated from UGA in International Affairs, and this is where I met my beautiful wife, Meredith, and we had our three children, and we started a family here. Why am I running for U.S. Congress? Because for the last 8 years, we have been told, give us a House, give us a Senate, and give us a presidency. And what have we done? Because it's not all good news. I am sick to death of career politicians who don't hold town hall meetings in person. I am sick to death of the fact that we are still funding things like gun control, Planned Parenthood to the tune of $500 million. I am sick to death of sanctuary cities, domestic spying. I am sick to death that we are still funding Obamacare. I am sick to death that they are taking the lives of my brothers and sisters in service and as veterans flippantly. And I am sick to death for the 21 trillion other reasons that they have compromised my children's future. I look forward to earning your vote May 22nd. And fighting the establishment in D.C. Because with you, we can bring the Constitution back and we can restore this republic. Thank you.
At this time, we'll move into closing statements, and we'll begin with Mr. Woodall.
Well, I got to begin with you, and now I'm getting to end with you. I appreciate you coming out tonight. I'm proud of what we've done together for 7 years. I'm thrilled about this campaign that we're going to have. We get to choose who we are as Republicans. Day in and day out, we show up together and we're able to make a difference. We're able to make a difference when it comes to tax reform. And that bill is different and better because you and I are involved. We're able to make a difference when it comes to spending. And yes, we are spending less because you and I are involved. We're able to make a difference with our neighbors. It's been over 1,300 pieces of casework we've had a chance to work on together for our neighbors who are grappling with the federal government just this cycle. 50,000 pieces of correspondence that we've traded back and forth as we've worked to try to make things better. But folks, I'll tell you, this is just the sideshow for all Republicans across the country this primary season. The fight comes in November. And if you tell me that we're going to run on how angry we are instead of the lowest unemployment in 50 years, the highest business optimism in two decades, the lowest number of layoffs in 50 years, the highest rate of school completion education that we've seen. Folks, we are getting it done together. This fight is going to be over folks who aren't sure whether America should look more like Elizabeth Warren or Donald Trump. We've got a chance to tell our story of success as we have experienced it here locally and as we've delivered it in Washington, D.C. I'm asking you for your support and for your vote, and I thank you for being here tonight.
Thank you, Mr. Hazel.
Thank you again, everybody, for coming out and listening to this. I really do appreciate it. Ladies and gentlemen, the arbitrary federal government that we have now is a crisis of our time. I believe the constitutional government is the fix, and you've got to have a fighter for that. I swore that oath to uphold the Constitution, and that means more now than it ever has. We have got to get back to some sanity and lead by example. That's why I'm leaving after 8 years no matter what. That's why I will not be taking the health care that's provided by our government at that level, and I will not be taking the pension plan either. I look forward to earning your vote May 22nd. I believe we need a principled, proven fighter in D.C. to represent the Georgia 7th District, which is my home. I appreciate you guys coming out. Thank you for the Republican Party for putting this on. I will see you guys around the Georgia 7th District and everywhere else I find you. Good night.
Thank you, everyone, for coming. We hope to see you on May 2nd. Thank you, sir.
I just love the two of you.